crucial difference between ourselves and the enemies we face today. In it lies the absolute unity of our life, opposed to the oneness of the evil we face. Here is our strength, the source and promise of victory. We of the United Nations know that our faith cannot be broken by any man or any force. And we know that there are other millions who in their silent captivity share our belief. We ask the German people, still dominated by their Nazi whipmasters, whether they would rather have the mechanized hell of Hitler's new order, or, in place of that, freedom of speech and religion, freedom from want and from fear. We ask the Japanese people, trampled by their savage lords of slaughter, whether they would rather continue slavery and blood, or in place of them, freedom of speech and religion, freedom from want and from fear. We ask the brave, unconquered peoples of the nations the Axis invaders have dishonored and despoiled, whether they would rather yield to conqueror or have freedom of speech and religion, freedom from want and from fear. We know the answer. They know the answer. We know that man born to freedom in the image of God will not forever suffer the oppressor's sword. The peoples of the United Nations are taking that sword from the oppressor's hand. With it, they will destroy those tyrants, the brazen tyrannies past. Man marches forward toward the light. I am going to close by reading to you a prayer that has been written for the United Nations on this day. God of the free, we pledge our hearts and lives today for the cause of all free mankind. Grant us victory over the tyrants who would enslave all free men and nations. Grant us faith and understanding to cherish all those who fight for freedom as if they were our brothers. Grant us brotherhood and hope and union, not only for the space of this bitter war, but for the days to come which thou and must unite the children of the earth. Our prayer is for the small star in the great union, the great union, the great union, the great union.